Welcome back to PRI, your Prep Recruiting Insider. I'm Coach Rick Gailey, along with the Prep Recruiting Insider, Renee Nado. And we're fortunate today to have two young men in this segment from Warren Easton High School. First wide receiver, Tyron Johnson. Thank you for being here, Tyron. And also Dedrick Shy, cornerback. And transitioning to the cornerback position from wide receiver. Thank you guys for being here.
And Rick, you know, the thing is, this is our second year in a row that the New Orleans area can boast the number one player in the state and the number one wide receiver, Tyron. And first of all, you had an opportunity to go up to Beaverton, Oregon at the opening. And how was that? There was a lot of talent there and kind of put you to the test a little bit. How was that experience up in Beaverton?
It was a great experience. You know, it'll give you a test, you know, see how good you really are going versus guys that's just as good as you.
Now, you have some visits coming up, and I know everyone's, everywhere you go, they want to know where you're going to go and things. Do you have a few schools at the top of your list, and where are you visiting right now, Tyron?
I'm visiting Texas Tech, official visit this weekend, actually. You know, I'm going up there in Lubbock. You know, I don't really have any other visits set up, but that's one for sure. I'm taking this Saturday.
Okay. And Dedrick, you have some offers, ULL, Louisiana Tech, I know Ole Miss and Georgia. Yeah. Or looking at you really closely. Any idea when you're going to pull a trigger? Or you have some official visits coming up?
No, not really. I let my coach deal with it. Right now I'm just worrying about my last year, my senior year.
And coach, as Coach Rick Gailey said, you transitioned from wide receiver to cornerback, and that's kind of a situation that you raised your hand a little bit. You wanted to play, and you got great size, 6'2", as a cornerback, and that's got to help you a lot. How has it been moving from wide receiver to cornerback?
You know, I played football my whole life, you know, coming growing up, so it wasn't that hard, you know, going to receiver, going to cornerback. Just playing football, you know, so it's not that hard.
Good. All right, guys, as I mentioned to you before, I'm going to talk to you right now as if I'm the recruiting coach, and you've got to sell me on offering you a scholarship. So, Dedrick, if we go with you first. Won't you tell me the qualities that you have, both physical, mental, educationally, that's going to make me want to give you a scholarship?
I'm hardworking. Don't give up. If you fuss at me, I'm going to try to get better every play, going after every play. Anything you tell me to do, tell me to run through a brick wall, I'm going to a brick wall. So that type of player I am. I'm going to push to get better every day.
I appreciate that. And Tyron, what about your qualities?
I'm very passionate about the game, and I'm gonna be very hungry and more hungry than other guys. I'm gonna bring that intensity to practice. That's gonna live it up, and I think I'm a team player, and I'm very aggressive, and I'm just like motivated by a lot of things, and I just want to be great. And if a coach give me a shot to be great, and I'm gonna make that big play for the team.
Last year, Leonard Fournette came through here, and he was a top-rated player in the country, in the state, and you're kind of pretty much in that same realm. Have you had a chance to talk to some players that have been recruited, maybe the Leonards or the Speedies or guys who have come through here in the past, and kind of get their feel on what they're going through?
I talked to Leonard. You know, one of the players on our team was cousins with him, close friends with him. Mm-hmm. So when I hung out with him, Leonard was with him, so we got to turn this topic up. But to say Leonard was the top player, he didn't really talk about football, so he talked about football at Blue Moon. But he gave me a little advice, like, you know, it gets aggravating at times, people keep calling your phone, trying to recruit you, but he just, like, enjoy the process and just, you know, make the right decision.
Now, do you have a date that you're going to decide where you're going to attend college? Is it going to be at an All-Star game or what?
At the All-Star game, unnamed game.
Okay.
Yeah.
And Dedrick, do you have a time where you know, you may decide when it's going to be? I know you said you can consult with your coaches a little bit, but
no, not really.
Okay.
Yeah, he's going to let his coach do it. That's a good idea.
Go. That is.
Because the most important thing right now is that they play good.
Yeah.
That's really, really important. Dedrick, I'm going to ask you this first. When you were growing up, what team did you particularly follow? Was your favorite team, or what player did you pattern yourself after?
Randy Moss. That was my role model. It's still my role model right now.
Hopefully he was your role model as a player.
Yeah.
That was interesting. What about you, Tyron? Who was some of your favorite players or favorite teams growing up?
I had a lot of players I looked up to. You know, Randy was one of them. You know, Reggie White, Brandon Marshall, a lot of receivers I looked up in the pros. And I never really had a favorite team. You know, Saints, who that? You know, that was my favorite team. And that's who I looked up to.
That, you know, because of how smooth you are getting out of breaks, a lot of people compare you to Odell Beckham. Yeah. Last week, 195 yards receiving, 3 touchdowns, and you had a little case of the flu. Every time you step on the field, you're going to get, you know, because of your high rating, you're going to get the opponent's best game. Get a little trash talking sometimes, people challenge you?
Yeah, a lot of people trash talk me. They see where my head at, you know, and they'd be surprised that I don't tell nothing back. And I just be so focused on my game, and, you know, I'm going to beat you with my talent, not with my mouth.
And Dedrick, having at practice, it's so competitive, going against Tyron and some of the other guys. How does it help you develop your game?
Make me a better cornerback and a better football player. Understanding the routes, the coming out the breaks. When you go inside release, you got like a post or a dig. You know, playing against a good receiver going to help me in the long run when I make it to college.
So. And Dedrick, I'm going to ask you this one first. You're making the transition from wide receiver to corner instead of running forward. Now you're having to run backwards all of a sudden. Yeah, even defensive coaches even draw plays upside down. That's a whole nother show unto itself. Tell us about that transition. Would you rather play man-to-man defense or zone?
I'd rather play man-to-man, man-to-man or D.
And that's what you do a lot of, isn't
it?
That's right. And at 6'2", you hope to be the shutdown corner.
Yes, sir.
And what about, what skills have you learned and are really working on right now? Because you know you want to make progress through the course of the entire season. Tell me what today you're going to be working on in practice.
I'm mainly working on speed, you know, and agility, trying to get more quick and more faster, because I know at the college level, everybody, you know, running 4.4, all the DBs running 4.3, so get my speed up and coming out my breaks faster. So by the time I get to college, I'll be ready. I'll play my freshman year.
Good. Well, thank you, Tyron. Thank you, Dedrick, for being here. We really appreciate it. Great representatives from the Warren Easton Eagles. We are at NOLA Motorsports Park here in Avondale, your prep recruiting insider, PRI. We'll be right back with two more terrific athletes from Warren Easton at NOLA Motorsports Park. Welcome back to NOLA Motorsports Park in Avondale. This is Prep Recruiting Insider PRI. I'm the coach, Rick Gailey, here with our Prep Recruiting Insider, Renee Nadeau. This is the home of the 2015 Indy Grand Prix of Louisiana. What a tremendous event that is going to be. And we're joined by two more athletes from the Warren Easton Eagles. First of all, quarterback Deshaun Capers-Smith and defensive end Kendall Franklin. Gentlemen, thank you for being here today. It's really a pleasure to have people from Warren Easton and the great presentation that y'all make.
Thank you. You know, Tyron Johnson was on a little while ago, and I call him ATM because he's always open and he pays off. But Deshaun is the guy who, he's the straw that stirs the drink a little bit. He's played wide receiver, quarterback, little cornerback. I mean, you do it all. You've already committed to Texas A&M. We're going to talk about that. But out of all the positions you play, Deshaun, what position do you really like, or is the most challenging and most fun for you?
I think it's cornerback.
Okay, why?
Because it's, as me playing receiver, I mean quarterback, it gives me a chance to know what is the coverage, how would this cornerback do what he has to do, but playing in college, I think it'll be a good fit for me.
Now, you're committed to Texas A&M right now, and is that solid? I mean, is the visiting over?
Yes.
Okay, and what did you like about Texas A&M?
Just the atmosphere, like just not playing football, but people around it. And so everybody's opened up to you. So I think it's a good fit for me. And yep. I'm sorry,
go ahead.
And it's like not too far from home, but it's just a get good away. So.
Kendall, you committed to Arizona. 17 sacks last year, 20 tackles for loss, 8 forced fumbles, and you had an 8 tackle game this past week. Why Arizona, and what attracted you to the Wildcats?
Well, talking to my head coach, Coach Hall, talking to Coach Richard and Coach McGee, it was more of a coaching staff connection. Because I know if I go somewhere, I'm going to play good football, but it's just talking to coaching staff, because you got to know there's going to be people there to have your back, do anything. So after talking on the phone with Coach McGee, talking to Coach Hall, talking to my dad, Coach Hall just said he felt like it was a great choice, so anything Coach Hall feel good, I feel good with.
And he says McGee, he's talking about Calvin McGee, who played at Booker T. Right. So, yeah, that's that New Orleans connection.
Here, that's right. And well, so is Rich Rod. We know Rich Rodriguez very well when he was offensive coordinator at Clemson. I had an athlete of mine, Chad Jasmine, play in his offense there. So I visited him several times. We had a lot of discussions on offense, a terrific coach. Now, I'm going to ask both of you, Kendall, we're going to start with you first, about your qualities. If I'm a recruiting coach and I have a scholarship that you want, you need to be able to convince me that I need to give it to you. I only have so many, and my family likes to eat. So the better you play, the more food I get. So Kendall, tell me about your qualities as a player that would make me want to give you a scholarship.
Well, my qualities, I feel like I have a motor. Like, I don't just want the sack, I need the sack. Quarterback has something I want, I feel like I have to go get it. I just feel like as an overall team player, anything you ask me to do, I'm there, no questions asked. I'm gonna go get it. That's the best way I could put it. I'm gonna just make sure anything I need done is gonna get done.
And I happen to see you in the scrimmage against Chalmette. You like to come really hard off the edge,
yeah,
don't you?
Yes, too.
But you're gonna have to learn how to drop in college probably, because you're gonna be some type of in between, inside, outside linebacker off the edge.
Yes.
Okay. Tell me what I need to know so I can give you a scholarship.
Well, me, I like to bring the spark to the team. So if I need to do something that needs to be done, then I just know I'm gonna do it for you.
And being a quarterback does give you a head start on,
yes,
on being a defensive back, because I coach Corey Webster at St. James, and he went to LSU as a receiver and then moved to cornerback, and it worked out very well for him, didn't it?
Right.
So that is really good, a good quality that you have.
Now, Deshaun, there's a lot of New Orleans guys, Louisiana guys for the Aggies. Who have you kept in touch with? Anybody on the team right now, players?
I haven't talked to Noel in a while, but I've been keeping up with him.
Okay, Speedy.
No, Noel Ellis.
Oh, Noel Ellis. Oh, yeah. Okay. Okay. And also, you are a great baseball player, outfielder, good hitter. Got a little baseball in your background.
Yeah.
You want to play both sports, don't you?
Yeah, I thought about it.
Is this something you've worked on a little bit with your coach, that Coach Sumlin, that I like to play baseball too?
Yeah, I never talked to Coach Sumlin about it, but I asked him, and you know how many people play baseball also, that was on a football team, and he told me Johnny Manziel, so I thought about it. I thought about playing it.
Okay. Kendall, since you've already committed, are the visits over?
Yes, basically.
And Coach Rick was asking about, jokingly with Coach Hall, about defense. Why can this team be special? Because the offense is going to put up some points, but the defense is going to win some games. Why do you feel good about the guys, the other 10 guys on defense with you?
I feel like no matter what I need, the other 10 on the field, they're going to have my back. They're going to play aggressive, and they're going to play hard. And long as we all playing aggressive, hard, and doing our assignments, ain't nothing, no offense can score on us.
That's right. Kendall, growing up, tell me about a favorite team or a favorite player that you had growing up that maybe you've used as an example.
I'm a Pittsburgh Steelers fan myself, so okay. Troy Polamalu. And I know it might sound weird as me being a D lineman, outside linebacker, loving on the DB, but his playmaking skill, his playmaking ability it intrigues me. He wants to be the one to make turnovers happen and just cause ruckus on the field.
And he is all over the place. I've looked at the Steeler defense a whole lot, and a lot of times they've come up with a scheme that just gives him a free reign to go where he wants to go. We've seen him leap over centers before, yeah, tackle quarterbacks immediately. Deshaun, tell me about a favorite team or a favorite player growing up.
Well, y'all ain't gonna believe it, but I'm a San Diego fan. When Drew Brees was there, that's who I really love, Drew Brees. So wherever he goes, I go. But my role model is Richard Sherman. I've been looking up to him, watching what he do, and just carry myself to see how he carry himself. So whatever he does, I'm just gonna try to be a little bit better. But I love how he plays the game.
Yeah, highly intelligent young man. Sometimes gets a little bit out of control.
Yeah.
But as a player, is just outstanding. And anybody that knows him, and the same thing with Troy Polamalu. People who know him love him, and that's a great quality. Well, I want to thank you, Deshaun, Kendall. Thank you both for being here today, being a part of PRI. Good luck to both of you, and Thank you for making such a good presentation.
Thank you.
For the Warren Easton Eagles. We'll be right back after this short timeout from NOLA Motorsports Park. We're here in the Event Center, 64,000 square feet, both upstairs and downstairs, for your next big event. We will be right back. PRI for the legend of the game.